Live from the Sunshine State, this is Hoppy Hour.
The following thoughts on Hoppy Hour do not represent Cox Media Group or its sponsoring. Anything you hear may and will be used against you. Thank you. Voted as best local podcast in Tampa Bay by the Creative Loafing. You're listening to Hoppy Hour.
I mean, that was the first thing he said to us. So that shows that that's top of mind, like he's feeling awesome today.
Well, yeah. Like, I used to think about, like, pussy a lot and getting laid, and it's just, that, like, wraps up your mind. And, I mean, we'll talk about that on the podcast. I'm at this point where it can come to me. Like, there's no reason to get wrapped up in it. You know what I mean?
Well, it's true.
Yes, there is.
Once you have, what do you call it, Fudge? Would you call it regular, or what do you call it?
You mean like when you're getting it regular, you mean, right?
Yeah, when you're getting it regular, you do notice that there's options coming out of the woodwork left and right.
Oh, yeah, whereas, girls can smell it. Girls can
And in other words, when you're getting it out in the regular, you don't care. So when you don't care, like you said, Ryan, it comes out of every angle.
Yeah,
so you're probably right.
Here, let's save this. This is way too good. Here, let me get Adobe open.
Oh, wait, we're not live?
Oh, wait, we are recording. I actually was recording all of this. We can keep this in there. All right, let me do my important intro. All right, here we go. What up? What's happening? This is Hoppy Hour. Don't laugh at me, Abe.
That's the intro.
I'm not done, Abe. You want to laugh?
Yeah, let him finish. Shut up, Abe. Let him finish.
Yeah, I know. Sorry.
Yeah, dude. Sorry I don't do radio like you, Abe. You badass. You're so cool, dude.
It sounds good, actually. You said you were doing the intro, and then you said, yo, what up?
That's how I do it, dude. You got to be excited. You can't be like, hi, this is Hoppy Hour with no excitement. You got to pump up the crowd. Everyone who's listening.
That's a good point. He meant some kind of big production intro, like
yeah. I thought you were getting
he expected the Alan Parsons Project. Of, dun, 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 and I'm like Michael Jordan.
Yeah,
come on.
No, like the Fox fanfare thing or something. Like do 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 do. But go ahead. Sorry.
You're the same way, Abe. You just begin your show by going, "Yo, you there?" I mean, come on.
That's a fair point. That's a really good point, Ryan, actually. Yeah.
Thank you. I mean, how have you guys been? I'm really pumped to get this segment going because I originally was going to have Brian on the show. And what happened was I had the post on Facebook, and then Abe sends me a message saying I should be on the show with Brian. And I was like, why not?
You asked me to be on. So I said, well, I see the Sludge is coming on, so why don't you just talk to us both at the same time?
That's what it was.
Classic Abe fashion, he bogarted it.
Yeah. Classic Abe. He had to get involved. I mean, do you want me to do the intro? Because I was doing the intro, Abe, and then you interrupted me like the radio professional that you are. Come on. Ridiculous.
No,
all right, here we go. Are you guys ready for the intro? Because I was born ready. All right. What up? What is happening? This is Hoppy Hour. I am your host, Ryan Hoppy. And on the phone line, I have two great guests. Come on. I'm a kid with a passion for this business. And you call into my show and mock me? Get the hell out of here.
Hey, be good for like, just let him do the intro.
That was you laughing.
It was me, yeah.
Yeah, that's what he's talking about. That was you. No, go ahead. Go ahead, Ryan. Sorry.
Are you sure you want me to do it? Because then you guys might just laugh at the same time if I keep on doing it.
No, I'm gonna actually put my phone on mute until you're... Go ahead, do it.
All right.
I'll do the same thing.
On the phone line, we have Abe Cannon from the Abe Cannon Show and Man Cow's Morning Madhouse. And also, we have Brian Haddad, a.k.a. Sludge, from WIP in Philadelphia. What's up, guys?
Well, first of all, it's Brian Haddad. You got to get the names right.
Oops, my bad.
It's not a big deal. It's a hard name to say. Stop correcting Abe.
No, I actually feel bad about that. I'm the one that's talking smack to Abe, and then I didn't even get the name right. My bad.
It's fine. It's all good.
How has everything been for you guys? I mean, you guys are in different cities, but I feel like you guys talk a lot. So how's everything been for both of you?
Abe, do you want to go first, and then I'll go?
No, you go ahead, Sludge. You've been in the industry you're one of my mentors in the industry, so you should be able. You should be going first.
All right. Yeah, things are great. I mean, I'm doing nights on a sports talk station, which I'm coming up. I can't believe it. I'm coming up on 4 years here in Philadelphia.
Damn.
I know. Isn't that crazy? Yeah. So in January it'll be 4 years, and the transition from doing like rock morning show stuff to sports talk and doing it in a city, you know, with some of the craziest mofo fans all over the place and a bunch of teams that suck, honestly. So it's been it's pretty crazy. Yeah, I mean, it's amazing when I look back on it now, you know, how leaving like that world and doing this world, which they have a lot of similarities, but it's been a real good challenge, and I've loved it. Things are going good.
How about for you, Abe? How's everything been with Mancow's Morning Madhouse?
It's good. You know, the only bad thing is that every morning I scream fuck, like when that alarm goes off, like 3:05 a.m. Like you can't, like even when you don't want to scream fuck, it's like fuck. And even without thinking, it just comes out of your mouth when it goes off. You, Sludge, you remember when you did morning radio? It's the worst.
Yeah, it is. It's, you know, it's with me, like when I moved here, so I'm doing nights now, 6 to 10, and it took me, no joke, like 7 months. I felt like I was detoxing, like I was in rehab from the 7-year lifestyle of getting up at 3 a.m. And I didn't realize it, that for that 7 years, I was actually a zombie. I wasn't like me, like, because I was falling asleep at work here in Philly at like 2 p.m. the first year I was here, because I couldn't get out of the mode of the morning, like you said, the morning radio, where when me and Abe did it together at one point, like, we never like crashed out. Like some morning guys go to bed like at 6 p.m. and we were going out and getting hammered. And then like at just like 1 and sleeping like 2 hours. Then we like going to a morning show.
How do you do that?
Every day.
How do you do that? It's insane.
Well, it's all about taking naps. You got to take, like for instance, I just ate Portillo's. I had a bacon double cheeseburger and fries at like, I don't know, like 2 o'clock. And then I took what's known as a hard nap. But a hard nap is one of those naps that you pretty much go into a deep sleep and you wake up feeling like complete shit. And especially after eating a bacon double cheeseburger. So I had what's known as a hard nap. And I feel like such shit right now that, Ryan, before you called us, Sludge called me. And I was actually in the middle of brushing my teeth. That's how disgusting I felt. In order to do this podcast, I had to, like, wake up, wash my face, brush. Like, that's what happens when you take a hard nap. You feel like you've been laying. Like, what was that terrorist named Sludge, that they found in a pile of mattresses? The guy with the stretched out white V-neck shirt on.
Oh, that's what he
that's what you feel like. When they found that guy laying in mattresses, like, that's how you feel after a hard nap.
Yeah, when I worked in a radio show out there in Cleveland, it was the same thing where it's hard because I would get up every morning at 4, and then once you're done at like 11 and noon, you want to do something with the day, but then you just end up like taking a nap on the couch. You wake up at like 3 or 4, and you're like, God damn it, I got to go back to bed in 4 hours. Like, isn't it a weird like cycle you live?
Yeah, it's horrible. I mean, if you start working out, you can get on a good track, but then if you miss like one day, then you won't work out for like 9 months.
I'm doing that right now, dude. I got to get back to the gym. Ever since Thanksgiving, I've gained like 4 pounds and I'm skinny, but I'm losing the muscle because I take creatine like a douchebag.
Creatine.
So like, I got to get back in the flow.
Ryan?
What's up?
Just do the HGH and get over it. Don't try to go some help. I mean, like, creatine and just go right to the HGH and just get it over with.
Could you imagine me just ripped? I'm goofy looking as it is. Can you imagine me like sloth, just like ripped?
Yeah, it'd be like,
Ryan, are you like 6'8 or something? How tall are you?
You guessed it, Sludge.
Because I'm 6'4". I know Abe's like, what, 6'1 or something, 6'2?
Yeah, you're short.
Yeah, like right in between 6'1 and 6'2.
About being, like, I've noticed like recently, I'm getting in pictures and I look like fucking Frankenstein. Like, I can't look good in any pictures.
Well, because you're next to
I never noticed this at all, like, I don't know, years ago. Maybe because social media, you take a lot more pictures or whatever and they're better, high, you know, better quality than you did back in the day. But I just don't like the way I look in any pictures. And I try to even kneel down. Hot chicks will get these pictures. And I look like some monster in these pictures with hot chicks. And I'm like, I've got no, like, confidence anymore. Oh, I say, no, I don't want to take a picture. Just, you know, whatever.
Well, that's your problem, though, is that when you kneel down, it makes you automatically look dumpy. You have to keep your posture in the pictures. Let them adjust to you. You don't adjust to their shortness. Let them adjust to your tallness.
Yeah, it sucks.
Isn't it weird how different moods bring out different pictures? Like when I met Joe Madden, I was so pumped so that my smile was so real. But like if you're taking a picture with somebody and you don't want to take it, you don't look as like flattering because you're like, can this picture be over with? Like, isn't it weird how some pics end up really good and then some are crappy just based off of your mood?
Yeah, and one thing I notice is that I like taking pictures with ugly people because then it makes you look better. So like if you have two ugly friends, you should take a picture with them and make it your profile picture. And I recommend that if you're at a bar too. Like Sludge, we know some slobs that we would hang out with, and then it makes us. It's like standing out in like just a big pile of dog shit. Like, oh well, they don't look
too
bad, I guess.
Yes, but to counter that, much like the girls that are quote Instagram models. As a profession, if you're getting pictures with slobs, you're like lumped in with them, and people think maybe you're just having a good day.
Like
if they don't know you like that, you're like a two-face just having your best day in that picture, and so you want to probably be in a picture with a bunch of good-looking people so you actually match up.
Was that you I was talking to about that we should start up a company where we take like great Facebook profile pictures, but we make it look like you're out at a bar. Like I have a system set up for like a bar. Oh, okay. Yeah. I said, Ryan, you might want to get in on this company with me where we start up a company where we like these dumb morons who take these, like it's all they care about. They go to bars just to take Facebook pictures.
Oh,
right?
They're the worst. Oh my God. Here in Tampa, there's all these douchebags who take selfies of themselves and they take like five rounds of them to get the right angle. I'm like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
It's the worst.
What we do is we're going to have ugly girls working for us to get into the pictures with these girls who are kind of dumpy, but they're going to look really hot because we're going to put the lighting on them perfectly, but we're going to make it look like they're either at a bar or it's going to look like an actual shot at a bar, but it's really set up in a studio. So they can all have these pictures because that's all they care about anyway.
There is a big problem. Like, if you go to, like, a bar, Sludge and Ape, you'll just see all these people my age just taking selfies and not really appreciating the moment. I'm like, what's that picture going to do? Like, in 10 years, are you going to look back and be like, wow, I had so much fun at the bar when I took this pointless selfie? It's ridiculous. You agree with me?
I actually, the thing that sucks, though, like, I wish I had... I want to, like, you ever seen the movie High Fidelity?
No.
Yeah,
with John Cusack, like, how he goes back and finds all his old girlfriends, the ones who broke up with him. I would like a better track record of all the girls I hooked up with because they didn't have social media back in the, well, you just got to go back like 8 years. I don't even have pictures of these girls that have some kind of track record that at one point in my life I actually could get with someone that wasn't disgusting. And I don't have that track record now because those pictures are all gone.
Wait, are you disgusting women, though?
No. What? I'm with no one right now.
He says,
I had a pretty good track record.
That's what I was going to say.
But I don't have pictures of them because social media, I guess social media has been around since, like, I don't know, 2006 or so. So it's been about 9 years. I have some track record of my successes. But not a complete track record. I feel like it's an incomplete resume of my work. And I wish smartphones were around earlier.
You need me as your wingman again to get laid again. Because when you and I would go out together, you'd have the hottest shit.
I want better proof of that. I feel like there's some lost data in the metrics of my life.
Sludge.
Yes.
Which girls are freakier? The ones that are, like, ugly or the, like, 10 out of 10s? Which ones are freakier in the bedroom?
That's not a black and white issue there. Because, I mean, there's some from column A and some from column B.
What are you doing to bring out the freak in them? Are you just like, I'm sludge. Watch out. What do you do?
Well, alcohol? No, I'm just kidding. No, girls either are or they aren't. You don't know until you kind of get them back to your crib, you know.
Have you ever?
I wish I had a better lesson for the kids out there, but you just don't know. Do not judge, a book by its cover.
No, but fuck, he wants to know what your moves are. What do you do to get laid? Like, what are your moves? He's saying.
Oh. you mean like once they're already back to the. I already got him home?
Yeah, when you're walking back to your apartment and you're trying to make the move and she's on her phone, what do you do to get her in the zone so that you bang her out in like 5 minutes?
I grab her phone and throw it to the ground and step on it.
No,
I'm kidding.
don't you come in with a rubber band on your balls and you say, let's party?
No, that's exactly not the move to do. I'd never, ever do that move. No, girls want a confident dude. Let me put it that way. Like, you got to make the first move.
What do you do? So when you go to the bar, do you have your...
This is going down a path that's going to sound horrible.
No, Sludge, he wants to know, like, do you whisper in their ear? Do you, like, kiss their neck? Do you just show them the sledgehammer right away?
Do you give them a hickey? What do you do?
Hickey.
No hickeys. But don't push it. Like, don't go too fast, because that's like a girl. If it's going to go fast, the girl's going to start that stuff. You know what I mean? Like, if the guy starts that, it just shows he's insecure. Like, you know. If it's going to be a fast, hookup, it's going to happen the minute you walk in the door, and she's going to start that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's true.
What's it like when a girl makes the first move? How hot is that? Because I haven't experienced that yet in my 22 years alive. It's ridiculous.
That's too bad. The first move is the best when the girl, that's like, layup. You know what I mean?
Because you're like, really?
Do you turn on some music? What do you do to get the mood going? Do you turn on some Marvin Gaye or some like Skrillex? What do you do, Sludge?
I usually put on Pantera.
That's true, actually. He does do that.
Yeah. You know what the best thing? Okay, I'll give you something. This isn't recent, but this worked, believe it or not. So. And this is kind of relating to a current story of Playboy getting rid of a naked chick. Because, like they said, that story, Pamela Anderson's going to be the last chick.
Yeah.
So it's a little lesson for the kids out there. So I used to have a subscription to Playboy. Like, I got it for free because of the radio station. And I used to have Playboys all over my studio apartment. Like, literally, there were stacks of them everywhere. And my sister-in-law came over and she goes, if a girl comes over your house, and these Playboys everywhere, they just figure that you rub one out all the time. Like, that's what they think. And I go, really? So she told me to clean them all up, but I didn't. And one specific girl comes over, sees all the Playboys, and she starts looking at them, and like, oh, my God, this girl's so beautiful, and this girl and that. So we, like, looked at Playboys together, and before I knew it, we were both naked, and it was a wonderful experience.
Nice.
So... Don't, like, see, the thing is with women, like, I think women, here's what I believe. All women are either lesbian or bi. There's no, like, there's no straight women. And I believe there's even a study in Sweden that backs me up on that.
That's like, totally true, actually.
That, like, there's no, like, just straight women. They're either bi and they haven't gone that way yet, or they're lesbian. Be like open to that kind of stuff. If you get a girl back to your house, like, have some maybe erotic materials laying around. I'm just saying it's worked for me in the past, and it could work for you too.
Should I go to like the local sex shop and get like a hardcore Lisa Ann porno and just have it laying on my table and be like, this is what I'm into, honey?
Well, it seems like since you haven't had a girl make a first move in 22 years, maybe that's a take a chance on that one. Take a risk.
Plug it in and be like, this is what I'm into. And she has like five guys around her.
Yeah, maybe that's not a good move. Playboys are much more soft. Playboys are much more Cinemax, you know, soft core. So, yeah, maybe that. Maybe not right.
See, I'm a very awkward guy when it comes to being at the bars with girls. Like, I just kind of think about what I want to say next. Like, how do you talk to girls, basically?
You want to
take this one?
Well, I mean, you know,
here's the thing. Here's what I would say. Just treat the girl just talk like yourself. Don't change. Don't do something stupid. You know, just go up and say, what up? Here's the thing. What's the worst that's going to happen is you're going to go home and you're going to be upset you didn't say anything all night. So why not go say something to any girl, and if you get laughed at, so what? At least you tried. I'd rather be go home like that than go home and say, God, I should have said something.
And Ryan, I'll add this in too. Your best chance of getting laid is to talk to friends of friends. So if there's some like cute girls at the radio station, you should make sure not to hit on them. But if they go out with their friends, you meet up with them, and then automatically she'll be like, oh yeah, Ryan's a nice guy. He works with me at the station. Then they already know you're safe. Then you could just have a regular conversation. And then while you're being hilarious in the circle, some girl will be like, what's his name again, Ryan? Oh, my God, he's so hot. And then you'll be banging her in the bathroom.
Have you ever banged out a girl in the bathroom, Abe? Have you ever been blessed with that classy opportunity?
Other places in public. Yeah, I'm trying to think of a bathroom. I don't know about a bathroom, per se. But, I mean, it's not like it's out of the possibility.
That'd be like Tony Montana's sister in Scarface when that guy took her to the bathroom.
Tony. It's not for you. You know, Frank just died the other day.
I know. I saw that.
Robert Loggia.
Yeah.
R, as in Robert Loggia. There was a Family Guy episode.
Yeah, we played that this morning, actually.
Family Guy sucks, by the way. One of the worst shows ever. Screw that show. Ridiculous.
Wow.
What, Family Guy?
That's a hot take, Ryan.
Okay, it was funny for like 4 years, and once they did Bird is the Word, and then it's like, all right, enough. Like, it's sad when American Dad's funnier than that show now.
I actually agree somewhat. Like, Family Guy, I don't watch it regularly, but it's funny.
Yeah, I don't
kind of know where, you know, I kind of agree. It's funny, but I don't laugh at it. That makes sense? Like, it's kind of funny, but I don't really
laugh at it. Well, like, The Simpsons, too. Like, The Simpsons haven't been funny in at least, 20 years?
Right.
But I can turn on, I don't watch even South Park regularly anymore, but I can turn it on, and I'll laugh out loud at South Park like, right now. They still do it. Like, it's amazing how they still nail it, South Park. I can't believe how they still nail it.
My favorite show is Aqua Teen Hunger Force. It's my favorite show of all time. Have you guys seen that on Adult Swim?
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't
in a long time. I have not. Space Ghost, if I go back way back to Adult Swim, Space Ghost, Coast to Coast is my favorite.
Harvey, Birdman, C-Lab. Dude, all those shows are classic. Yeah, dude.
We just got away from banging chicks to talking about cartoons all of a sudden.
Well, that's my life. No wonder I'm not getting laid. I'm watching Aqua Teen Hunger Force in my free time.
Ryan, what do you so when you go out to a bar trying to get laid, what do you do? Do you just like hang out in the corner with a smile on your face? what's your method of trying to get laid?
I don't know. I'm actually pretty sad, dude. My one friend who's my new executive producer for Happy Hour, he's like my wingman, and like, he'll get the girls to come over, but I just don't know what to say. Like, it's sad. Like, the conversation is so awkward. He said he can see my face melt because I get so nervous.
Can I give you a great tip?
Yeah.
Now, I've never, believe it or not, even smoked weed, okay? And Sludge can confirm this. I've never done any drugs in my life, okay? But I think that every single guy should be carrying drugs on them all the time when they're at a bar, if you can't get laid.
Why?
Anytime you're at a bar, there's always girls who want to do cocaine. They always want to smoke weed. When I think back, if I would have had drugs on me every time, you end up back partying with them, and then probably things are going to happen because you have the drugs and that's all they care about. So, Ryan, if you're really just trying to get laid, always carry, like, cocaine and weed on you everywhere.
Sounds like a good idea.
That's like the most awful advice I've ever heard.
I know. Abe, you've been one of my mentors. You've given me legit advice in life, and now you're saying to carry coke? Way to go, buddy.
No, but I'm not saying do it yourself. But they're always like, hey, okay, let me give you an example. So I was at a bar, like, I don't know, last year or something, and I ordered a Red Bull just by itself. Or no, wait. First some girl goes, hey, do you want a party? And I'm like, oh, what? What do you mean? Like, do drugs or something? She goes, yeah, cocaine. Or she said, I forgot how she said cocaine. But I ended up, she wanted to do cocaine. I'm like, no, I don't do that stuff. So then I go, hey, can I have a Red Bull? And then she said, I can't believe you drink that poison. I'm like, wait a minute. You just wanted to do cocaine with me, and now you're calling Red Bull poison. So my point is that she's a fucking dumb moron. And if you had the drugs on you, you would have been in a situation to probably get laid. I mean, obviously, it's not good advice, but if you're desperate to get laid.
I'm not desperate. I don't know what I am. I'm, like, sexually angry. I'm just, like, I'm so used to being rejected that I'm, like, whatever. You know what I mean?
Have you ever had anything? Or?
Yeah, I've had sex, like, 4 times. I banged out this one. Yeah, I banged out this one bone fan last month. It was so random. I'm here editing my podcast, and she begins hitting me up. So I drove like 40 minutes away, had sex, left. It was amazing.
So what did you do? You walked in, and what? You just right away she started going down on you, or you start making, like, how did that work?
Basically, the first part you said, it was insane. I mean, she's just like, so when are we going to do this? I'm like, no. So the clothes come off, I bang her, and then afterwards, she's like, do you want to watch some TV or something? And I literally was out of breath. Like, it was like I ran a marathon.
Did she look good or not?
She's not bad. I mean, she's had 2 kids, so she had a slight tummy, but it wasn't bad. When she went south of the border, let's just say I was in utter awe.
And then why don't you keep that? See, now, if you were smart, you keep that in your regular rotation until you get something better. So in that way, at like 2 a.m, when you're at the bar looking around, you can just send her a text, hey, what are you doing?
Well,
and then you could get that regular going.
I don't think she gets laid a lot just because she has kids. So she said I made her climax 2 to 3 times. So what I'm getting at is I think the reason she never hit me up again and we would talk back and forth is because she was just really horny that night. I helped her out, and now she's like, whatever. Like, that's what's annoying. I thought we might be F buddies or something. Nope. Just a one-time thing.
So you've had 4 one-night stands? Is that what you've had?
Oh, here's the best part, Abe. You're going to love how I lost my V card. This is great. So this fan of the show I worked on in Cleveland, when I tried out for it, I came back to Chicago. So both times I tried out, I drove there and back. The second time I came back, this girl hits me up. And this is after I got catfished on that video. And she's like, oh, I feel so bad. Do you want to come over after we're talking back and forth? I go there. She's a 49-year-old MILF. And that's how I lost my V card.
49, Jesus. Wow. Well, you haven't even been in that area of age, have you?
Yeah, that's like in my wheelhouse too, probably, right?
No, but you've never had anyone close to 49, right?
I don't think so, no. Like, maybe 40s, like early 40s, I'd be 40, but not 49.
Yeah, but early 40s when you were in your 40s, not when, what are you, Ryan, like 25 or something?
22.
Oh, even, yeah.
Yeah. The oldest, I remember when I was 24, I had a girl 32, and that seemed like unbelievable. That seemed like, it didn't seem, because she was hot, but it was like she made all the moves. And but I mean that seems like weird to me. So I can't imagine what a double age would have felt like.
Dude,
more than double age. That's double plus 7.
Dude, the best part was during the whole time she kept saying Poppy.
25, right?
No, I'm 22.
Oh. Damn.
Oh, I think of it as grandmother.
Dude, the whole time she kept saying Poppy.
Girls can look like, but girls today, man, do like CrossFit and everything, and she's a MILF. You said MILF, so I assume that means, you know, you want it, you know, one you would want to, right? So I assume she looked, well, what actress did she look like?
I'm not sure. She was a little worn out.
Fucking Pee Wee's Big Adventure. Happy March. Adele. Oh, she looks just like Adele.
Dude, I bet Adele's a freak in the bedroom. Wouldn't you agree?
She's like Charlize Theron and Monster.
Lita Ford in 2015. Hey, Ryan. So she tells you she feels bad for you. She's 49. She invites you to her house.
Basically, the best part is she was right next to O'Hare Airport, so I'm banging her out as the plane's going over. She keeps saying, oh, Poppy, while Petey, I don't know what she was, while Petey Pablo Freak-a-Leak is playing, and then Lil Jon. Quite the playlist.
Wait, so she's a 49-year-old, she's an old white 49-year-old, and she's playing Lil Jon, and she's calling you Poppy?
Yeah.
So what? So how do you? But how do you, I'm trying. I want to get to the bottom of it. How do you set it up? Like, you walk in, she starts making out with you, and takes you right to the bedroom, or what happened?
It was weird. So I walked in, and I was even more awkward back then. I've grown up since then, but it was weird because I just walk in. And what was weird was this is right when those Bill Cosby accusations came out. So I'm trying to put my arm around her and, like, make out with her. And on the news is Entertainment Tonight talking about Bill Cosby. So I'm, like, trying to change the channel. I'm like, Jesus Christ, is that a mood killer? So we begin making out. Her bra comes off. And then I'm like, let's go to your bedroom. And she's like, okay. So then it happened. And I banged her, like, four times, too.
Did you use condoms, I hope?
Yes. I also took a pill before, a boner pill.
Sludge, you're the... You've taught many young men about condoms. Maybe you should give Ryan that speech that you gave me when I was a young twink myself.
The speech that never jump out of a plane without a parachute? That speech?
I think that was it.
Yeah, no matter what the girl says, I don't believe her. Look at Charlie Sheen, for God's sake.
Well, that's common sense, because there's this thing called lying and not being truthful. So if she says, I don't have herpes, then she probably has herpes.
Right.
Yeah, that's scary, herpes. Like, just think about that. Herpes, it's like you can't even see it, right? And then you end up with it all over your neck or something. Wherever herpes would go.
Well, to be accurate, I don't think you can see any STD before it hits you, before you have it. Like, I don't think you can see it.
You can see HIV.
No, you can't. On some night, you can't see it on a...
I'm just joking.
You know what, though? I thought you were actually... Because I could see you actually making an argument for that. I've seen HIV before.
Well, if they have lesions all over their neck, like in Tom Hanks in Philadelphia, yeah. Then I'm like, wait a minute, you have a...
Well, that's a symptom.
Yeah.
I love how we went from talking about, like, your life to cartoons to now HIV. Like, Abe, have you ever banged out a girl with HIV? It sounds like you know a lot about it.
No. You know what? I here's my rule on HIV. I believe once you have HIV, then you have to retire your dick. Like, you can't, like Charlie Sheen. Oh, yeah, I've had sex twice, unprotected sex under my doctor's supervision with HIV. Not only should you not be having unprotected sex with HIV, you shouldn't be having sex with a condom on with HIV. Once you find out you have HIV, that part of your life is over, I think. I don't think – all you should be doing is jerking off, because even if there's a 1% – like, for instance, if I gave you, 50 Jimmy John subs and I filled one up with poison, I wouldn't eat those. I wouldn't pull one out of the bag of 50, you know, because I might pull the one with the poison in it. So I would, you know, it wouldn't be worth it. So I think that's when you go into retirement, when that happens.
That's a good analogy from you, because you probably quest or crave Jimmy John's stuff the same that you crave sex. That's a good analogy you made there.
Oh, thanks.
And I'm not saying I'm not partial to a gargantuan as well. Although I'm not trying to say I'm above you by any means.
Although you are above Abe, let's be honest here.
Well, yes, he's one of the. I'll tell you this, Ryan. So I started at Q101 when I was 19 years old, going into 20. And Sludge, I was working with Mancow right when I was like 19, 20 years old. And Sludge was the afternoon guy at Q101. And I would go in that studio. Almost, how about it, Sludge? Every day we would have these long conversations about everything. And Sludge is one of my mentors in the game. And then we did a morning show together. So you never know what's going to happen. Like, Sludge, you and Ryan might end up doing a morning show at some point together. Who knows?
Hoppy and Sludge in the morning. That'd be kick ass.
Wait, your name is first?
Damn right, dude. I'm the young, up-and-coming talent. You're the old guy.
Oh, I'm the old guy.
Damn.
That means, I have the cred already, though, you see.
Sludge is in the cred. You know what? Like Bono.
What's that?
I said Sludge is the Bono of radio, like from U2, still in his prime.
That's right. You can't, I only get stronger.
I do believe that, actually. If you look, Sludge, you probably are at your peak right now.
Well, I'll tell you, I looked my ass off in this stuff because I still do the production here, too. So, I last week, I had a couple, like, 14-hour days. I'm not trying to pat myself on the back. I'm just saying. I see some young whippersnappers, not like yourself, Ryan, because you're obviously pretty motivated, but I see some people that, you know, don't know that you have to actually be uncomfortable when you're trying to get to the top or whatever, trying to get somewhere. If you want something, you know, you have to sacrifice. I don't think anybody – I'm not trying to make all those blanket statements about people that are 20 years old or whatever, because I've seen some, you know, but there's – there's definitely something different going on. Like, I mean, I think it started with participation trophies at some point.
Oh, it's true, dude. I mean, here at the Bond, we have a really good promotions team. But, I mean, I went to this radio school, and everyone just, like, assumed graduating there was just going to get you a job. And I'm just like, nope. I put in 1,400 hours in a year there. I mean, people just don't want to work hard. It's odd, my age. They just want to have it given to them. Utterly ridiculous. Like, it's funny. All the kids that used to make fun of me in high school, oh, you want to go into radio? Now they kiss my ass online. Oh, I see you're working in Tampa. That's cool. It's just funny how once you get your foot in the door, anything's possible. You know what I mean?
Yeah, don't get hung up on that, though. Like, I hear the anger in your voice. You don't want to be one of those angry radio guys that got picked on in high school and now... oh, I'm taking it out now. Because it's going to turn you into an asshole. Don't get, like, hung up on that kind of shit. Just like, be happy with what you're doing. And I tell people this all the time, too. High school is 4 years. If you're still talking about high school at 30 years old, your life has been pretty shitty since high school. Like, I don't even think about high school anymore. And really, high school doesn't matter at all. Those 4 years, it's like, okay, it's cool or whatever, but it shouldn't define your life. And I recently went on... with some guys from high school, they're talking about high school football game. Yeah, man, I remember when we played Providence, man. We remember that 4th and 1. It's like Jesus. Your glory years were from the ages of 14 to 17, two of which being 14 and 15. Those are two of your glory years in your entire life. So you don't want to get who? I mean, all the guys in high school that were like running shit in life, they're not running anything.
No, I was going to say, it's funny you said that, because I just said, like, I've been here almost 4 years now. Well, in January, it'll be 4 years. And I actually thought of that for a minute for some reason, because I was on Facebook and somebody I went to high school with said something. I thought, damn, like, high school, you know, people still, and I'm older than you guys, so, like, people still talk about high school. And I've been here where I feel like I've been here just for, like, a minute, and it's already the length that I was in high school.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm going like, dang, high school was like, I get it that when you're that age, you take everything more seriously because it's when you're like growing from a whatever, you know, and it's awkward and all that stuff. But still, like, time hasn't really gotten faster, even though it seems like it has. I'm like, man, I've been here in Philly where I feel like I just got here as long as I was in high school almost. I'm like, damn.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, it's weird. When you have fun and you love what you're doing, time just goes by real fast. Like in school, it's just the clock could never reach 2:45 soon enough. I mean, you just hated every second of it. But now it's like the amount of time from, like, let's say winter break to, let's say, summer break, that's how long I've been in Tampa. I'm the same way with you, Sludge. It's like, it's just weird how time was different back then. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Amen, brother.
Amen, brother. Hell yeah, brother. Hell yeah, brother. Now, I know on social media you're very critical of the Kardashians. Now, today it was announced that
who gives a shit? Oh, those dumb whores. Oh, enough of them. Good riddance.
See, Ryan, this goes back to the anger with you. I think one thing that's going to hold you back in the industry is your anger. Like, I hear the anger in your voice. You need to talk about the Kardashians in a comical way instead of, like, just calling them dumb whores, because everyone calls them. Like, the dumb whore thing, everyone says, oh, they're stupid whores. You should say, like, they're calling him Saint Robert Kardashian. Now, Robert Kardashian is the guy who got O.J. Simpson free. So they're basically, she's like, my dad's a saint. That's what she's basically saying with this new kid. How fucked up is that? That she's celebrating a scumbag by name? Is that verified, Ryan? Is his middle name Robert? Is it Saint Robert West?
How come you want to know this much about their kid? I saw that the kid's name was Saint West, and I closed the internet. You know so much about this, Abe. I respect it.
Well, it's very important information. Are you still there, Sludge?
Yeah, I'm just fine.
What do you want?
I'm listening to your logic.
Are you on a treadmill? It sounds like you're on a treadmill or something.
I'm doing what?
It sounds like you're on a treadmill.
No, I'm not on a treadmill.
It
what
does.
Position are you in right now? Sludge, are you laying on your stomach right now? What position are you in?
I'm laying on my couch.
Okay, because I'm laying in my bed with only boxer briefs on, with the phone jammed between my head and the pillow. That's my current position.
I am almost in that same position on my couch. Same deal. In just
no shirt on?
No, I have a shirt on.
But just boxer briefs?
But I am just in my boxers, yeah.
And Ryan, you're fully clothed, right?
Yeah, I'm at the bone right now.
Oh, shit.
Please tell me you haven't used, like, a fleshlight during this or anything weird, because I don't trust you guys.
Fleshlight? No, not yet. I don't do that till when I'm about to try to fall asleep. Wait, what's a fleshlight? Is that a dildo or something?
Yeah, it's one that you, like, put on when you're about to, like, I don't know, jay off. I'm trying to think of a clean way to say it.
No, not yet.
Yeah, I'm not really big into, like, those toys. Like, I feel like creeps are the ones that, like, pay for that, like pocket peas and that. I just watch porn and I get it done. Like, I find porn to be sad. You know what I mean? Like, once I'm done watching it, I'm like, I just watched a movie of people having sex. You know what I mean?
It is weird if you had a daughter or something, or your sister.
I've been thinking about that, too. Yeah.
Yeah, so it seems like if you go to that next level, like, you've crossed something you can't go back over, like you, with sex, anything sex toy related. Like, once you cross that barrier, you can't go back. You can't go back to being a pure, like, an innocent human being again.
Yeah, because you'll always be remembering the time that you had a ball gag in your mouth for, like, $90.
Yeah.
Or you're eating out of a dog bowl.
That's why we found it weird. Like, that's why I'm creeped out by hookers, because I'll go to bachelor parties and there'll be lines of guys waiting to go in the bathroom to get, like, blown by the stripper. It's like, wait a minute. Why would I want to follow you guys? Like, I don't even want to be first in this rotation, just knowing about all the shit she did before, probably. But now all your buddies, yeah, man, you get one? No. Because I don't want her to have a mouthful of you when she's creeping up on me. Let alone just the fact that she uses baby wipes probably in between sessions. Now it's like they have time to take. I mean, do hookers, a good hooker, does she have time to take a shower in between every single client? No.
Imagine again, everything on her.
This is a barrier you cross and you can't go back over again. This is a barrier you're just a different person. After that point, when you cross that path, you're a different person now.
Yeah. And some of the girls look really sad in porn. Like when they're in some, like, let's say there's that one act at the end of the porn, target practice. That's like the most demeaning thing ever. Like, it's just sad.
Yeah. It's like a baby bird waiting for a worm.
It's just the saddest thing. It's just like, what led you in life where you're going to let a guy demean you like that? You know what I mean? Like, and then they'll go on, like, radio shows. They'll go on radio shows and say, oh, I love being in porn. Nobody loves doing it. Get the hell out of here, unless you're like Ron Jeremy.
Well, you know what it is? Probably a guy demeaned them at some point, which made them go into a profession of being demeaned by men. Like, their father, some asshole boyfriend, someone fucked with them in some way where that's what, you know, that's what they do now.
It's just...
Yeah, I'm sure if you talk for just a, it only takes a few minutes to get there in the conversation with them, I'm sure. So where'd you go to school? Oh, yeah, they had a good football team. And then one time with my uncle, and then you just start when it's all over. So, you know,
my uncle took me tailgating, and then...
Yeah. And then like, that's pretty much it. I bet, if there could be like a timer at the game show, in how fast you can get to the problem with the porn star. You could get there under like 40 seconds in most cases.
Dude, it's crazy. You'll look up their work.
But I'm not hating on them. I'm not hating on porn stars because me and Abe, actually, when we did the morning show, lived together, we had a porn star stay with us for a couple days.
Did you guys Eiffel Tower her?
Yeah. No. Actually... She just sat in her pajamas on her laptop for a couple days and smoked weed out of a Red Bull can in the morning. It's all
no, out of an apple. Out of an apple.
Oh, yeah.
It was actually Tara Ray, Wayne Static. Wayne Static just died. His widow.
Yeah.
Like, what do you talk about to her? Like, can she hold a conversation? You know what I mean?
Not really. I mean...
She was actually a normal chick. I remember we had her on the show and... She was actually like a normal chick. Like, you would never know. If I remember right, maybe I'm not remembering everything exactly right, but she was cool. I remember that.
Here's what you learn, Ryan. Unless you really, really like someone, I'd rather just hang out with Sludge than any girl. You know what
yeah.
I mean? Unless it's someone that you actually like. And like you said, if you're leaving after 40 seconds, then you're better off just hanging out with Sludge. That's what I always find. Like, I don't want to talk to Terry. I want to talk to Sludge.
How important is talking to a girl for you, Abe? Like, do you guys have to hold a conversation? Or if she's, like, very hot, can you deal with the dud that she is when it comes to talking?
The older I get, I'm having more and more problems dealing with stupidity, to be honest. Like, their stupidity is almost outweighing their hotness at some point. Like, just... how about it, Sludge? Do you agree with that or no?
It's not necessarily stupidity. It's talking about things I don't want to talk about. So it's like, that doesn't mean they're stupid. It just means you're getting in conversations about a hike that they may have had over the weekend on this great hill somewhere park and how we should go there. But it's overly detailed. And I agree with Abe that the older I get, I have less and less tolerance for conversation that I don't want to waste breath on.
Yeah, and you'll find that when you don't care who it is, you immediately, as soon as you, like you said, Ryan, once you drop that load, all you want to do is get the fuck out. You don't even want to sit there and talk for 2 minutes. So
that's how I was.
I'll even give you a recent example. That this was, really recent, like a month ago, that there's a girl that I was hanging out with that looked like, I'm not exaggerating, I swear, looked like Jennifer Lawrence.
What?
I'm not exaggerating. And the first time hanging out, I realized I can't take her conversation at all. I can't even tell you how angry I got at the conversation. And I said, what? And, but she was that good looking. So I had repeat, you know, I kept hanging out with her. And I never closed the deal because she was very slow. No, not right. That's what I'm saying.
You?
And I kept, but I'm just giving an example here. So it just never got to the point to close the deal. And but it was literally the fourth time of hanging out. Nothing even close. But because she was that hot, I gave it that many opportunities. And then finally, I pulled the plug. I go, this is not going to happen for whatever reason. I can't say I hated myself for hanging out with her. But because she was so hot, the potential was there. But then so I think it's like you said, it doesn't matter. There's this point when you're going to hit the point where you say, fuck this, I'm out. And that's what
I did. How far did you get? What did you do with her?
Barely anything.
So you did nothing at
all? Not nothing, but barely anything. So I saw it, but this was going nowhere. And I'm not trying to say I want to just sleep with a girl. I mean, this was like after 2 months, I think.
What?
And
you?
Like 2 months. I know, me, Abe. Me.
What's the world coming to?
But the thing is, I gave it enough rope. I said, like, you know what? This one deserves a little more rope because of her hotness. Like, I'm going to give it a chance here and see what happens. And literally nothing was going down. And I even confronted her then. Like, look, if you just think I'm your friend, that's fine. But just tell me that. Because I'm not, and she was like, no, I'm attracted to you and blah, blah, blah. And that kind of thing. And I go, okay, cool. But then I gave it like 2 to 3 more. And I could still sense, I could sense this is not, something's wrong here. And I got to tap out on it. And that's very rare. Very rare, but I tapped out. And then she's calling me like Saturday nights at like 1 a.m. And here's one of my willpower aids. I didn't pick it up. I didn't answer texts. I'm done because I know where it was going to go. And I said,
maybe at that point, though, she might be thirsty now. And she'd be like,
no,
an opportunity with the sludgehammer.
No, it isn't. I know it. Trust me. She crashed in my house and nothing happened before. So I knew nothing was going to happen. Something was wrong. Something's wrong there.
And I would give it one more chance, dude.
No, because that's what I was doing. Listen, Ryan, this is the lesson I'm going to pass on to you. You have to know when to tap out. You will know. Despite you think you don't have any instincts, you do have them. They're in there. And when you have that instinct, go with it and tap out.
Wait, plus, and very important, Ryan, is you need to know when you have a window, you have to exploit it immediately. Like, sometimes you only have one chance to get into this window. Like, you have this open window. Like, for instance, the promotion, Tansy, the promotions girl, says, hey, Ryan, do you want to hang out after work? If you think that's your one opportunity because she got into a fight with her boyfriend, that might be your one chance. Like, she broke up with him, but they might be back together in 3 days. You might have 1.5 days in that window to make things happen. So anytime you see some kind of vulnerability, you have to pounce on it.
Wow, that was some really sexist advice, dude. Like, take advantage of a girl.
No, it's for women too. Women the same thing. If you like a guy, if he broke up with his girlfriend, he'll probably be back with her within a week. So you need to, you know, if you have that open window, you need to take advantage of it.
I'm going to take the route.
Well, that too.
No, go on.
I think this is an old example. This one goes way back in the day before I even met Abe. Which is seems like never in my life. Abe was never not in my life. Seems like. But this is when I was first in Chicago at Rock 135, and I was out. I thought of keep it short. So this girl, we had a couple girls that worked for us that were Chicago lovable cheerleaders, the dancers for the Bulls, and we went out with them one night, and one of their friends came along, and I'm not even exaggerating. This was over on Lincoln. Abe would remember the place, but so. Or you both would probably know it, but I think it was the place that was before the apartment. Anyway, this girl starts making out with me in front of everybody. Like,
one of the lovables?
One of the Bulls cheerleaders.
So the lovables.
The dancers. Yeah, the lovables, right. And she was blonde, like, ridiculously like, I'm trying to think of a girl she looked like. Maybe, what's the freaky girl's name in 40-Year-Old Virgin? The one that, at the end of the bathroom?
Oh, yeah, yeah, the blonde girl, the one who says, put it in my back seat or whatever. Yeah,
yeah, put it in my truck.
Elizabeth, like yeah, I know you're talking about.
Elizabeth Banks. Banks, I think.
Yeah.
And she's like, she just starts making out with me, like, it was embarrassing, actually. Like, she just, we're sitting at the bar talking, and she starts making out with me, and it wouldn't stop for, like, an hour. It was, and finally, I mean, everyone was just looking at me, and it was just it was embarrassing, but, of course, I wasn't going to stop, because it was ridiculous. So then I go, and she kept drinking more and drinking more, and both of us were, actually. And I didn't live that far from there. I go, well, you know, I'll go back to my place, blah, blah, blah. And she said, yes. We get back there, and she starts, and we're still making out, and then she starts throwing up. Okay? And then, like, I'm like, okay, I can still do this, whatever. But then I go to the bathroom, man, or whatever. Come back, and she is completely passed out in my bed, like completely passed out. And I am not going to get, I am not, you know, going to do something that, you know, no one's not a willing participant, of course.
Yeah.
So she's completely passed out, wakes up in the morning, she apologizes for whatever, and then I go, cool, let's hang out, you know, whatever, sometime. And then I call the other girl, as soon as I leave, when she leaves, I call the other girl that was the Bulls cheerleader that worked for us, who I know well, and I said, hey, what's her deal? And she goes, oh, she just broke up with her boyfriend like 2 days ago. So I think you're, you know, good. You know, you could be a good rebound guy. This was a girl wingman I had. I go, perfect. The next day, she got back with the boyfriend, and I never saw her again.
Yep.
Never saw her again. So I missed my window. It wasn't my fault because she got so drunk, she threw up.
You should have got her out of the bar earlier. That's the mess, right? You should have got her out there earlier.
Truth. I should have got her out of the bar earlier because I became babysitter instead of, King of the Mountain or whatever you want to call
it. And, Ryan, remember, it's a jungle out there. You have to – even if you're driving someone, you figure that out later. If you're that in this position right now where it's like you're just trying to get anything you can, if you're in a situation like Sludge's, you get out immediately. Like, if you – like he'll get – he messed it up because the puke messed everything up. So you immediately get her out of there.
That's some good advice totally because you don't want her to get too drunk. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Get around there.
I was drunk, too. That's the problem. My judgment was marred by me being drunk, too. my spidey senses were off to get her out of there. Because clearly, she had chosen me to get back at her douchebag boyfriend with, and now they're probably married with kids today.
Do you wish you were married, Sludge?
I'm ready to get married now, but but it took a long time to get there. I'm ready now.
Sludge, didn't you say you wish that you had a kid and that your wife died in a plane crash? Then you have the kid. You've said that like a million times.
No, keep it in context. I don't want anybody to die. I said... What was the conversation with that? I think it was...
That was it. You said you wish that you would have got married when you were, like, 21, have, like, an 18-year-old son now or whatever, and that... Or whatever. You got married early. You have a son or
I remember
daughter or
this. I remember why I said... Here's why I said this. Because everybody always asks you, and Ryan, you're probably going to get this eventually, like, when are you going to get married? When are you going to settle down and get married? When are you gonna, and I said... The ultimate way to get out of that would be if you got married at 21, had a couple kids, and then your wife died in a plane crash. That way, no one would ever ask you again about getting married because if someone was going to bring it up, someone else would go, hey, dumbass, don't say that. His wife died in a plane crash. Oh, I'm sorry. I won't bring
it up. It still hurts, man.
Like, it could be 30 years later, and no one's going to ask you that. No one's going to ever say that again. And you get your kids, because, like, I want to have a kid or two. So you have your kids, and there you go.
How often have you had that in your life where they're like, Brian, why aren't you married?
It's slowed down now because they've given up. My family has given up on it. But I have a bunch of older brothers, and they're all married with kids. So I have, like, eight nieces and nephews and all that stuff. So now that you pretty much just given up and figure out who I am. But now I'm at the point where I would get married. But the problem is that I probably missed a good girl to marry when I was just running through them. Like, I should have picked one of those girls and said, hey, this would have been a girl to marry. But instead, I was just, you know.
You were busy being dangerous. You were dangerous as that one girl.
That's right. I was busy being dangerous. That's right. So the lesson is you have to consciously be ready to marry. You're not going to see stars. You have to say, here's the thing. You got to be Derek Jeter. You have to be Derek Jeter. Because Derek Jeter banged about, what, 8 of the top 10 Maxim models and about 1,000 others we don't even know about. And then he's getting ready to retire. He finds the hottest chick around that's still left. He's 40 years old. Cool. I'm going to marry this one. And I'm going to marry this one before I get fat and disgusting when I'm not playing baseball anymore, even though I'm a millionaire. But I get the hottest one, that Hannah Davis chick, and boom. Derek Jeter should be – there should be statues of Derek Jeter in every city and about this is the model for men, what you should do with your life, how you should do it, whether you have millions of dollars or not.
George Clooney did the same thing. He banged everyone around. When he turned, like, 50, then he's like, okay, I'll settle down with this chick.
And she's not that hot, though. It's weird. His wife's not that hot.
Yeah, I mean, she wants to do something, though. You know, that like, she wants to be good at something.
I bet they have a lot of threesomes, then. There's got to be something that drew in George Clooney to marry her.
I mean, she's probably, well, she's successful. That's one thing. Like we were talking about, maybe she's a good conversationalist. I'm sure most of George Clooney's girls are just morons. Like the Leo DiCaprio girls, I'm sure they're really dumb. But he has no problem with it. That's another guy. He's on the beach, 40 naked girls around him. At some point, you would think that would dry up, but maybe he'll just keep, maybe he'll be like Charlie Sheen and just keep that going forever. Who knows?
No, he's like, is he engaged now?
Leo DiCaprio?
Engaged. Yeah, I think, didn't he get engaged to one of those Sports Illustrated swimsuit models? I think he did.
Oh, he did? I didn't know that.
I think so. So, yeah, even he's saying, like, you know, like you said, like, 40 naked girls laying around. So, like, he's, like, going like this. Whatever. like, that's what Leo's doing.
Like, he'd rather hang out with sluts.
Yeah, even Leo would rather hang out with me at that point. He's like, God, I wonder if Fudge is playing Halo. Maybe I could go over there and play Halo with him.
Think about most of the dates you've been on. Wouldn't you just rather hang out with me? Besides, obviously, when you get into your the sludge den, whatever you call your bedroom. But besides that part of the night, wouldn't you rather just be hanging out with me the whole night?
Sure, no question. No question. I've laughed more with AIDS than I've ever laughed with a girl.
Aw, that's very sweet.
Ryan, have you ever laughed with a girl?
I'm not sure. I don't think I've talked long enough for that to happen. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he's like, no, hookers don't laugh. They just want their money.
Yeah, you know,
I always said this too, Ryan. You know, if you're having that much of a problem doing that, you should consider getting hookers.
Like clean hookers. Because I would rather earn the one-night bang than pay for it. I mean, with that money, you can, literally buy an Xbox. Like, it's such a waste.
Well, it's like Sludge said. I think that's one of those things, like, you never go back. Like, once you turn that corner, then you're probably always going to be like, oh, I could just get a hooker.
Are you on Tinder and stuff, Ryan?
Oh, that's trash. I have this one girl's number. She's really cute. What happened was I played the move of, here's my number. If you ever want to hang out, text me. So we've been sending texts back and forth, but I'm trying to figure out at what point do I ask her out, because I can read you some of the messages. I mean, she thinks it's cool. I'm on the radio. We're talking back and forth. I'm getting to know her. But at what point do I ask her out? Do I wait for her to text me this week? Because I sent her a text last night.
Just do it. Just do it.
Should I wait a day?
No, wait a day. We're doing swingers now. No, just do it. Just say like, hey, you know, I don't know what Tampa's what's like down there, but figure something out you like to do.
I don't know what it's like down there. Probably like every other place. I'm sure there's like restaurants and bars.
Because let me tell you something weird I just figured out. I think recently, because you're like, I'd say about, I think like online dating stuff's been around for like about 15 years or something, like back in 2000, I'd say.
Yeah.
And back then, everybody thought everybody on online and whatever were like predators and shit.
Yeah.
Now, we have this girl that I work with. She's like 25, and she's so hot. And she's talking to me about, she goes through a couple different boyfriends, and then she's talking to me one day, and she met some dude on, not Tinder, but some I never heard of
it. eHarmony, Plenty of Fish.
No, it's like, there's so many apps now. There's so many, like, app dating things. It's like this other one, whatever. And I go,
Grindr.
But I was just like, how do you, I said, why are you going to, like, one of those things? Don't you get asked out in bars or stuff? And he goes, yeah, but it's usually some creeper old guy, like a rich guy, or it's some, like, psycho. And I thought, you know what's weird? Is like, the whole thing changed. Like, bars are now full of the predators and perverts, and online is actually safe.
That's true.
So, like, online, it's like, all, like, I mean, a 25-year-old hot girl shouldn't have a problem getting asked out.
But she is. And it's like, that's weird. So she's going on.
You know what, though?
I
don't believe that, though. Because I know a lot of hot girls who act like that's the case. But there's tons of nice guys. There's tons of asshole guys. They have guys hitting on them everywhere, left and right.
But the nice guys aren't asking them out because they're afraid because they're hot.
Well, that's true, too. Yeah. Like, a nice guy like Ryan is afraid when, like, the douche. Ryan, I'm sure there's a douchebag in your office, right? Who gets laid all the time?
Probably.
Yeah, like, he'll just go right up to him and just start, like, what up, babe? And then they're making out. You've been working all night, and then he just walks into the bar and he's making out with her. Like, that's the kind of situation. Whereas, she's going to hate that guy in 3 months if she could have been with Ryan Hoppy the whole time.
Yeah, why be with the guy that's ripped when you can be with the tall goofball? You know what I mean? You have to pick and choose.
Hey, there's girls who prefer that.
Because then they can teach me the ropes of life and in the bedroom. You know what I mean?
That's true.
Ryan, you're like this big bear, Ryan. That's this big bear.
Yeah, with claws, man. That's a swinger. Have you ever seen Swingers? You should watch.
No, I'm not
Ryan,
old
Ryan,
like
Ryan,
you.
Before you go out, no, but it's still available. It's available on HBO. Okay? So watch Swingers and before you go out on the town. And just go by those rules, and you'll be fine.
It's a very good point. I mean, I'm ruining this great chance, dude. I'm in Florida. I'm in Tampa. I should be doing well for myself. Like, if you lived here in the 90s sludge, would you just be bringing girls back home every weekend?
In the 90s.
I live in the 90s.
like you're 70. You know, people back in the 90s.
You know what's funny, though? You look at the 90s, like it was like 20 years ago now. Well, the middle of the 90s is 20 years ago. That's fucked up. That's fucked up.
Dude, I was born in 93, so you're old.
The answer, of course, is yes, Ryan. Yes.
Yes. Sludge would be all over those. He'd be at the beach. He'd be banging them at the beach.
Yeah, you guys would be go on.
Don't waste your youth, Ryan. That's what I'm saying. Don't waste it. Just go out and be stupid. Don't be afraid to be stupid in front of girls. They love that stuff. I'm really stupid.
What makes you so dumb, Sludge?
Not dumb, but not afraid to be a goofball in front of chicks. Just be they you know, too many of the guys that are going to go in with, you know, the super tight Baby Gap black tee. And some Armani shirt with too much cologne on and a gold chain. Those guys don't deserve that pussy. You do. There you go. That's my pep talk.
Damn right. I like that. That should be on my LinkedIn.
Well, just a good closer for this podcast. You just dropped the mic.
I just dropped the mic.
That's a good way to go out.
You guys should be like Mission Impossible. We get like a Bluetooth and you guys see where I'm at in the bar and you guys give me like advice. You know what I mean? Like, that'd be perfect.
Yeah, I'm down for that. Wear one of those GoPro cameras.
Yeah.
And then I'll be in your ear. I'll be like, okay, now what you want to do is compliment her on her shoes.
You have nice shoes, baby.
That is actually a good line. Like, oh, I like your shoes.
Oh, really?
That is good, girl. Because you know why? Because girls spend so much time shopping for shoes. If a guy notices that, they're going to really appreciate that.
Oh, yeah.
But then they might think you have, like, a shoe fetish.
No.
You
have to present.
But if you present it in the proper way, they're going to be like, oh, thank you. I like your girl voice.
Thank you.
What are you, Bruce Jenner? What are you, Caitlyn Jenner?
Hey, where's Kimmy at? I'm Miss Kimmy, hey. Kimmy, I want to look like Kim. Hey.
That's my Caitlyn voice.
I don't know what that was. That was not Caitlyn Jenner.
That's what she sounds like. I want to know what it's like to be a woman.
I don't know what that sounds like. It's creeping me out, dude.
It's Caitlyn. That's what she sounds like.
I wonder what she's like to talk to.
What?
I wonder what she's like to talk to.
I mean, at this point, it's probably... I mean, what do you talk to Caitlyn about now? Nice dress or... I mean, it's like she's going to talk about the shit I want to talk about anymore. But then again, Bruce Jenner actually was a bore as a guy. He's probably more interesting now. Because he was, like, playing with helicopters and shit the last 30 years. Hanging out in the garage and then playing with helicopters.
How often do you watch this show? How often do you watch it, dude? Holy crap. You know so much about it.
No, I watched it quite a bit, actually. See, that's your problem, Ryan. You're not willing to do the right research.
I'm good.
Like Sludge and I want
sure.
Oh, Sludge, did you start watching The Challenge yet? I think it's back already.
Yes, it is back. I didn't watch the episode yet. Well, the first one was last week, but
shit.
Yeah, me and Abe both appreciate the MTV Challenge shows, which is something I kind of hate myself for, but it's my guilty pleasure.
I had John Jacobs on last weekend, the guy who was the funny guy. I had him on last Sunday. Do you guys know who that is from the show, The Challenge? John Jacobs?
What's his name?
John Jacobs.
No, I never heard of him.
No, he was on the show last year. He's funny as hell. He was like the funny, skinny guy. You guys seen him.
No. Yeah,
they don't get their last names on the show, so I don't. Yeah, they don't get their last names on the show, so I don't remember which guy it is. I can't remember like what his name was on the show.
Is it Johnny Bananas, or is it that guy, John... Johnny, the dude who's all like ripped.
No, it's not him. I'll send you guys the link. It was a really good interview. Like you would be surprised that it's someone from MTV. He's a really funny comedian here in Tampa Bay. We have a really good comedy scene, dude. I'm really getting into comedy in general.
Yeah, I want to come down there sometime. I've never been there. I want to go check it out.
Dude, I'll be up in Illinois in like a month. We should grab a beer.
Yeah, I'm always available.
There's that dead air of like, sure, Hoppy, whatever you want, kid.
See, here's what you have to understand. Even when my like friends of like 20 years want to grab a beer, it's always like I hate having plans to do anything. So anytime, even for instance, like even though I like you and I like Sludge, the countdown to do this podcast was like fuck. And that's not just you.
I was excited.
Ryan, listen. I do my own podcast every Tuesday, right? I have the same countdown to do my own podcast. I have the same countdown when I have to go to the doctor. I have the same countdown when I have to do anything. So anytime I have any kind of plans, that I like just doing things on the spur of the moment. Like, for instance, on a normal Monday, maybe right now I'd wake up after a nap and then go right to Jimmy John's. Now, I didn't plan to go to Jimmy John's. I didn't say, like, hey, I'm meeting you at Jimmy John's, Sludge. But if I knew that I was meeting Sludge at Jimmy John's, I'd be like, fuck. And then the countdown would be on to go to Jimmy John's with Sludge. I like to just do things whenever I want to do it. So, like, when you said, oh, I'll be there on December 17th at 9 p.m., I'm like, fuck. So now I have now I'm counting down till December 17th at 9 p.m. Now, if you were at a bar and you're like, hey, I just got here, I'd be like, oh, yeah, I'll come meet up. But if it's set up for 3 weeks, then I'm like, fuck. You understand what I'm saying?
That sounds really weird, dude.
I can appreciate what Abe's saying here. I can appreciate it.
Uh, What a podcast. An hour and 15 minutes of riveting gold. Wouldn't you agree, boys?
That was a good time. I
very good. And it was, man, and I appreciate you having me on. You're a go-getter, man. I like that.
Yeah, Ryan, I will say this. Sludge had a conversation about you. You are the very young, and I've never seen anyone as hungry as you are to get in the radio, so it's very encouraging.
Dude.
And you've asked me for advice over the years, and I try to be very genuine with you and try to give you – I don't want to just tell you that you're awesome because that doesn't help you.
Yeah, like, you've always been upfront.
Yeah, like if you ask someone – like, for instance, I was listening to one of your podcasts the other day. You're about a million times better than you were when you sent me a video, like, however many, I don't know, how long have you been sending me messages? Like, 2 years? 3 years?
3 years. Remember when I couldn't get a word out and my speech was awful? And I'm like, Abe, I want to be a shock jock. I put that in the email, and you're like, first of all, no, drop that word.
And I'll tell you this, too. You're able to just talk. You're able to do a podcast and just talk. Without any co-hosts or anything, that's a skill. And Sludge, I'm sure it was hard for you to adjust to that when you got to Philly at WIP to just be able to talk like that straight for 40 minutes without a co-host. That's a skill to have that. And Ryan already has that at 22, which is very impressive.
Right? Yeah, that's awesome.
You guys are flattering me. This is what I've wanted to do forever, so I just never let anything get in my way. That's how I see things.
Yeah, keep doing what you're doing, and then eventually you'll get a break, and then you have to exploit that break.
Damn right. Because what I like about you guys is you're just like everyday radio guys. You're not like hacks with like wacky names. I mean, Sludge is a wacky name, but like, you know what I mean.
You guys are with wacky names. Sludge,
that was awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. No, it's not, you know, it's funny. I've tried to get rid of Sludge, and it literally, no pun intended, I can't, it sticks to me. I can't, when I got here, I tried to get rid of it, and somebody said it on the air, and then everybody likes it, and now I use my real name, which I never used before on the air, but now half people call me Sludge, half call me Brian, whatever. But so it's good at least I have my real name now, but the name will not die. It's amazing. I thought I was using it. When I got to Chicago in 96, and I was doing nights, it was my first big job, really, and I was doing nights. I thought, okay, I'll do this for like a year or two with this name, and then it'll change. And that's amazing now. It's coming up on 20 years of using that name.
Damn.
I know, right? Pretty deep.
But anyways, Ryan, it was a pleasure being on the Hoppy Hour, and
yes, thanks, man. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, dude, this was a good time, man. I feel like we made it work. For us being in three different cities, this was podcast gold, as they say.
Excellent. Well, thanks for having us on, Ryan.
All right, sounds good.
Right on, man. Thank you so much, brother. All right, Ryan.
We're professional.
Thanks, man.
Thanks, Ryan.
All right, thanks, guys. All right, bye.
See you, buddy. Good luck, man.
All right, peace.
Happy Hour. Happy Hour.